Here in the WPI Archives and Special Collections, we serve to preserve the memories and traditions of the generations of WPI students that have come to make this place on the Hill the special place that we recognize today. One of the most cherished traditions was the freshman and sophomore rivalry, which bestowed upon its winning class the Goat's Head Prize. First presented in 1928 by Gompie Kawada's classmates from the class of 1893, this trophy now lends its name to one of the most prestigious awards given by the WPI Alumni Association. This award recognizes an individual for his or her lifetime contributions to the WPI community at large and reflects the friendship, support, and overall responsiveness to the needs and interests of our students, parents, alumni, faculty, and staff over the years. This special award is only presented occasionally and to the most deserving of recipients. Please join me and the entire WPI community in recognizing this year's special award winner.
Good evening. For those of you who don't know me, I am Mark McCauley, a member of the classes of 1989 and 1994, and president of the WPI Alumni Association. Thank you all for joining us this evening. I can't think of a more fitting way to conclude our homecoming festivities than by paying tribute to one of WPI's truly outstanding community members. A few housekeeping items before we proceed. First, I want to let everyone know that we are recording this event so you will be able to view it again later. I encourage you to use the chat feature here in Zoom to share stories about our honoree and to make comments throughout the event. If need be, you can reset the view on your own screen using the controls in the Zoom window and by clicking on this video window and relocating it. The Alumni Association's Citations Committee does an outstanding job each year identifying alumni and friends who have done wonderful things with their lives, including reaching tremendous professional achievement, providing exceptional service to WPI, and making a difference in the WPI community. Tonight, we present the Goat's Head Award for Lifetime Commitment to WPI to Janet Bagan Richardson, who served WPI for over 30 years. At this time, I welcome Mike Shore of the great class of 1992 as our Master of Ceremonies.
Hello, everyone. The award for Lifetime Commitment to WPI recognizes an individual his or her lifetime contribution to the WPI community at large and reflects the friendship, support, and overall responsiveness to the needs and interests of students, parents, alumni, faculty, staff over the years. The Alumni Association is thrilled to present Janet Bagan Richardson with this award. She joins an esteemed collection of past award recipients, such as Dean Emeritus Bill Grogan of the class of 1946, Bill Tuna Tresk, Father Scanlon, Professor Helen Fasalo of the class of 1982, Stephen Hebert of the class of 1966, and Trustee Emeritus Stephen Rubin of the class of 1974. We have two of our past honorees participating in the Zoom tonight. Good evening, Steve Hebert and Helen Fasalo. I'm so happy you could join us. Throughout this event, I encourage each of you to contribute to a word cloud or dropping a link into the chat feed now. Please share with us a word or two that you would use to describe Janet. We will take a look at the complete word cloud at the end of the event. Janet looks a bit nervous already. I am pleased to introduce our speakers who will pay tribute to Janet tonight with me. They're Joyce Klein from the class of 1987, Rachel Delisle from the classes of 1996 and 2006, Stephen Hebert, who worked with Janet, as I mentioned, as a member of the class of 1966 and a prior recipient of this award, Philip Clay, who also is one of Janet's WPI colleagues. I will call upon each of you when it's your turn to speak. I'd like to start with my tribute first. My relationship with Janet, where do I start? Maria von Trapp recommends, at the very beginning. It sounds a bit foreboding to share that Janet met my mother first. Thankfully, I was not in trouble. It was student parent weekend during the summer of 1998. The parents and the students were split into separate groups to get acquainted with WPI. My mother participated in a session led by Janet. She made an instant connection. That day, my mother introduced me to her. I was an out-of-state freshman coming from Maryland. I believe Janet sensed my mother's concern about her favorite child being so far away from home. Her fears were assuaged as Janet explained, WPI is less the Animal House experience and more like Pitch Perfect. I, of course, was hoping for something more on the lines of Weird Science. Not until the end of my freshman year did Janet and I become much closer. I applied to become a resident advisor through the Jumanji-esque interview process. The dynamic duo of Bernie Brown and Janet Richardson welcomed us to the residential staff and provided extensive training to prepare us for our landing on Omaha Beach. To this day, I still recite the six elements of the student wellness wheel, the WPI campus police extension, and my DACA card ID. Next 3 years as a resident advisor, Janet coached, mentored, and appreciated me. When I was the summer session resident advisor, everyone was enjoying their vacation with Chevy Chase. I remember Janet making effort to make sure I was not home alone. It may come as no surprise that at times I struggled with the decisions or logic coming from the housing office. Janet's door was always open for me. Several times she quelled Dante's peak bubbling inside me. And when necessary, she took action like Patton to do the right thing. Janet was always the ally of the student through her perspective. I felt pretty special. Side note, my mom still says that I am. I felt pretty special having this relationship with Janet. I had the ear of the dean of students. I quickly realized this was how she treated all students, faculty, and staff. Even though Worcester may not be an Emerald City, Janet has always been WPI's Glinda the Good Witch. 1 year I sat with Janet on the student council. She led this group with compassion, understanding, and fairness. I learned from her that even when you want the truth, but you can't handle the truth, sending a student to walk the green mile is not always the best scenario. I know her leadership and personal approach helped to form the basis of my management style while I worked in corporate America. I formed many deep relationships with students, faculty, and staff while a student at WPI. Nonetheless, I've always valued and considered my relationship with Janet as special. I am fortunate that she's still present in my life. Some special memories I've had to include and which Janet will remember was a special graduation reception in Boyne Hall to Janet and Bernie Brown my junior year when I received my bachelor's degree. A special feature included a cameo appearance by WPI President John Strauss to officially award me my diploma. I believe Paula Delaney's out there, and I want to give her a special shout out to Paula for her noteworthy role as the university registrar in this rom-com. Janet and I created secret pet names we call each other. You can keep guessing, but it isn't Bonnie or Clyde, Lady or the Tramp. Those make all too much sense, right, Janet? When I left WPI heading to Georgia Tech for my PhD, she had her brother in Atlanta reach out to me. Like Janet, a wonderful man, so warm and helpful. Janet visited me when I lived in New York to discuss the plans for the Student Center and potential donation of stained glass. With an unplanned work transfer to California, the size of the project had to be reduced, but the panel hung in the most prominent place in the Student Center, Janet's office. Coming back to campus as my honored guest when I received WPI's Distinguished Service Award and socializing with the class of 1992 during our 25th reunion, it was a blast. An honor to be Janet's friend for over 30 years. We have kept in touch and shared the ups and downs of our lives. I always value your input and insight, Janet. I am especially grateful you have taken interest in my life. There are so many of us, Ellen, Terry, Corey, Warren, Renee, to name a few, who'd like to thank you for your devotion and passion to the student WPI community. Perhaps I dropped in a bit too many references to famous movies in this Oscar-style tribute to you tonight, Janet. You're a star, baby. Tonight, you not only receive the Goodfed Award, but in my world, you also win Best Feature and Best Leading Lady. Here's looking at you. And feel free to start your acceptance speech with, "You like me. You really like me." Because we really do, Janet. But this time, I'm pleased to introduce Joyce Klein from the class of 1987, and she's also the vice chair of WPI's Board of Trustees. Joyce?
Thanks so much, Mike. I have to say, you're a really tough act to follow. Janet, I am so thrilled to be able to say a few words tonight. And I'm so thankful that the Alumni Association has decided to award you the Goat's Head Award for Lifetime Commitment to WPI. I remember when I was working on the board, at the time, those of us wanted to find a way to thank and recognize those individuals that had had a profound effect on us. And we were able to pull together the Goat's Head Award for Lifetime Commitment to WPI. Janet, you're joining a very illustrious and deserving group of individuals. We're fortunate enough to have tonight Helen and Steve with us. And it's such great news that the Alumni Association has selected you to join this group. I'm so proud of the decision that they've made. It means so much to the students, faculty, staff, and alumni that you've had an impact on over the years. So Janet, I'm gonna go back a little bit to when I was a student. When I was a student, you were the Dean of Students working with our good friend, Bernie Brown. One of your many responsibilities at the time was to be the overseer of the resident advisors, this eclectic group of individuals that you would bring together on a weekly basis. And for some reason, I remember us sitting in whatever basement of whatever building we were in, and we always sat in a circle. I don't really know why a circle, but we sat in a circle. And you use those sessions and opportunities as a means to convey messages to us. And those messages were about community building. They were about the need and desire for us to improve our leadership skills. They were about us learning compassion, listening. And you had your very subtle way of getting those messages out to us while listening to all the things that were going on around us. But you taught us so much in those sessions, so much about leadership, compassion, understanding, as I mentioned. You also had what I'm gonna call things that you wanted us to do in your role. And one of those was building a sense of community within the residences that we were responsible for. So I remember specifically senior year, your mantra about community. And I was the hall director in Stoddard. And we, those of us in Stoddard, took your message of community to heart. We worked very closely with our students at the time to pull off an event that we thought was gonna be an amazing community building event. And so the team at the time came up with a Jell-O wrestling event. And I remember when you heard about it, even though we were well along in our plans, you did not choose to basically have us halt the event. Rather, you let us go forward in your very nice way of kind of, okay, there's a leash, but I'm gonna let them not go too far. You let us learn. We had learned a lot about planning and pulling off an event like this. We had to coordinate with DACA to get all the Jell-O, campus police, et cetera. And then, you know, our event was in front of that, you know, common area in front of the three buildings that make up Stoddard. And you even showed up. You kept your distance, which was recommended at the time, so you didn't get pulled into the pit, but you let us learn. And I think that just speaks so much about you as a person and your style. And looking back, it's amazing, you know, that, you know, just all the things that you've done to help us. You know, I think also back to the times that your door was always open. And it was open, whether it was just a quick hello that we wanted to say, or whether it was a more meaningful conversation. You always had an ear for us. You always wanted to know how our classes were going, how our projects were going, what was happening about jobs, et cetera, for sororities, you know, and just our overall life on campus. And it was great that you were such a sounding board to myself and so many of us. As you saw from the tributes that were flying by in the beginning, everybody has things to say about you and how you treated us as a colleague, not as a student, you know, and in the sense that we were equals. And it was so nice, Janet. And I know, looking back as an alum, you were one of the few people that I sought out, along with Bernie and Bill Trask and Helen and Professor Sisson, when I made my journeys back to campus in terms of people that I wanted to see. And you were always a great sounding board, just checking in and telling us, you know, what was happening in terms of the life and activities at WPI. Janet, you know, I didn't appreciate it at the time, but you were quite the trailblazer. I remember when you were appointed VP of Student Affairs. You were the first woman vice president at WPI, and that's pretty amazing. You broke some glass to be able to do that, and I probably, as I said, didn't appreciate what all that meant at the time, but looking back now, that's pretty exciting what you accomplished and the value and contribution that you made for all of us. I came across a recent quote by Winston Churchill that I think summarizes you, and it reads, "We make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give." And Janet, I think those words epitomize you. So I'm going to say, on behalf of me and on behalf of all of those students in the 80s that you had such an impact on, thank you so much, Janet. You've meant so much to me, and thank you. It means a lot. So now I have the pleasure of turning it back, I believe, to our good friend Mike for a quick breeze before Nancy, you, but it might be directly to Nancy. So, Mike, Nancy?
Hey, Joyce.
Hey!
Thank you, Joyce, from the class of 1987. We also have your colleague, our classmate, Nancy Pimentel. So, Nancy, I'm going to transfer it over to you for some comments.
It was August of 1983 when a young, innocent, and naive woman began her undergraduate studies in chemical engineering at Worcester Polytechnic Institute. Eager to be a well-rounded student, this woman, during her freshman year, joined a sorority, the best one on campus, Phi Sigma Sigma. Auditioned for school plays, yes, engineers are thespians too, and applied to be a resident advisor in the dorms. It was here, during the interview process, that this woman met a one Janet Bagan Richardson, AKA the notorious JBR. Janet, having good instincts and a keen sense of character, chose this woman to be an RA in Daniels Hall the following year. I stand before you now as a spokesperson for this woman to let you know, JBR, that maybe your instincts weren't so good. In my hand is a list of some of the things this woman did during her tenure as an RA. Confessions, if you will. Number one, she broke up a party in the dorm and confiscated the keg, brought above said mentioned keg to her room, polished it off with five other RAs, names of whom can be supplied upon request. Number two, broke into the student affairs office late one night, made fake IDs for herself and other underaged students. Number three, stole the keys to the campus van and used it to joyride and bar hop around the city of Worcester. And number four, submitted a receipt to the student affairs office for reimbursement of a pizza party that never happened. Receipt was a fake. A dude at the Boynton gave it to her. Reimbursement money was used to buy clothes. You know, maybe this isn't the appropriate venue to point out your poor judgment in character, Janet. This is the time to honor you for your 30 years of service to the student population of Worcester Polytechnic Institute. When looking back at my experiences of you as a student advocate, I remember you being open-minded, direct, fair, communicative, optimistic, and most importantly, fun. Thank you, Janet, for your service and your contribution to my life and to the history of this institution. Number five. She often hooked up with a townie bartender at his apartment when she was supposed to be on duty in the dorm. But you know what? Thank you, Janet. And good going. You picked very well. Thank you.
Nancy, is that the police I hear in the background coming? Thank you, Nancy. Don't forget, folks, to contribute to the word cloud. We are adding the link in again to the chat feed again. So please contribute. We'd like to see these words. This time, I welcome Rachel Delisle from the class of 1996 and 2006 to honor Janet.
Thanks, Mike. I'm honored to help celebrate Janet and the incredible impact that she had on the WPI community. Tonight, it was easy for me to tie my usual WPI theme of family together with Janet. She's been part of my WPI family from the moment I learned who she was, because I hadn't even met her yet, and she had already become one of my WPI moms. So in true 28 years later there might be a couple more confessions coming tonight. It's a good thing we're too old to get grounded. So I'm gonna start in my freshman year. I lived on D3, and the girls on D3 had a great idea to get our RA Candy, a male stripper, for her birthday. And somehow Janet caught wind of this, and a message got back to the ringleader. Yep, fine, it was me. The message was, Janet found out what you have planned. She said, under no circumstances will this take place on campus. And I was all thinking, like, who's this Janet chick and why is she being such a party pooper? And that's when I was introduced to the concept of the Dean of Students. So we got the mom kibosh, but maybe not, because as the resourceful problem solver that I am, I traded a month of Sunday dinners and apartment cleaning with some friends and relocated the party to off campus. And it was very memorable. The first time I remember interacting with Janet was early in my sophomore year. I was pulled into her office by our dear friend, Warren Smale. He was student government president at the time, and he needed someone independent to help count ballots for the Senate elections. Mom moment number two, she came back to her office. She found we had taken it over completely. Surprise, we're here. And she wasn't even upset. It was like we belonged, and she kind of expected, like, okay, it was just like any other day. So it was pretty amazing. When I accepted the Boynton Award, I spoke of how Warren played an important role in me becoming a leader on campus and later in life. And I was remiss in not giving Janet similar credit, because you see, I was formally introduced and got involved with SGA when Warren appointed me a vacant senator position. And that would not have been possible if not in part for Janet, because when I met her that first time in her office when I was counting ballots, I was on academic probation. I had some fun freshman year, right? So she asked me about getting involved in SGA. And when I told her that I wasn't eligible, she essentially told me to get it together. So mom moment number three, thank you for the kick in the pants. That moment opened so many doors for me. It gave me access to leaders in the administration, faculty, trustees. I got to serve as a student rep on the Committee of Academic Operations, on the Committee on Governance. And I had an IQP experience that included sailing with an America's Cup team. None of that would have been possible without that. A short time after that first meeting, we heard a very scandalous rumor. Her husband worked at WPI. It was like a huge mystery that had to be solved. Like, who was her husband? What did he look like? We're all sleuthing out Don, you know, trying to catch a glimpse of him in the library. It was like a recon mission. Thinking back, I really do chuckle a lot at how naive we were, not realizing how many couples actually work together. But it was fun at the time, right? But Don wasn't the only part of her family that she shared with us. On occasion, her son Matt would stop by campus and hang out with us for a few hours. He was about 12 at the time, and it was a little bit like having a little brother. And what a great role model mom moment, because to see a woman in such a prominent position juggle work and being a mom. So mom moment, I don't know, I've lost count. There's more coming though. Matt wasn't the end of the family sharing. She also shared her late brother Tom with us. So keep in mind, this is the early 90s. The social landscape was very different then. People weren't out like they are now. And Janet was the first person that I personally knew that openly shared that she had a loved one that was gay and that she had lost someone to AIDS. She was my first example of what it means to be an amazingly unapologetic ally to the LGBTQ community. She exudes acceptance and love. Janet, I will forever be grateful that I have you as a role model in this respect, because if this isn't an awesome mom moment, then I have no idea what one is. She helped us protest to save Higgins Lawn from being paved into a parking lot, right? Giving us advice on the down low about how to be successful, kind of like a mom does when she publicly says that violence isn't the answer, but she secretly teaches you how to throw a good punch. I served on the campus hearing board my senior year, and through that, I was able to see Janet display her leadership, discipline, and compassion, realizing that all three could exist in the same person at the same time in a way that they didn't influence each other, simultaneously having compassion for a victim while maintaining the integrity and discipline of the process. After graduation, our relationship changed, and you became a true friend, catching up, offering hugs whenever I see you, continuing to share your family with us all, getting to see your world travels with Dawn as you enjoy retirement, seeing Matt, who in my head is still 12, be married and welcome your granddaughter Finley to the world. She is beautiful and she is very lucky to have you as her Mimi. I am fortunate to call you my friend. The impact that you've had on me personally as a student, a leader, an ally, and a woman is profound. Thank you for everything that you have done for me and for the thousands of students whose lives you've touched. Thank you for sharing yourself and your family with us. We will be forever grateful. I love you. Back to you, Mike.
Where in the world is Don? Don! Thank you, Rachel. Steve Hebert is a graduate of the class of 1966 who served in many leadership roles throughout his career at WPI. Steve, it's your turn.
Hey, thank you, Mike. Janet, this is a wonderful evening to honor and recognize you. You've been an incredible part of the WPI community for 30 some odd years and throughout its history. And I apologize for reading, but I'm just going to read a few quick notes here. Throughout its history, WPI's strength, despite its bricks and mortar presence, has come from the quality, commitment, and management of people. You have been the epitome of those three characteristics. As we've seen from previous comments, the respect, admiration, and love that former students have for you is incredible. And it makes it totally obvious why you were selected to receive this prestigious award. Having heard some of the things tonight, I'm wondering why you stayed at WPI with these folks, but be that as it may. I never had the good fortune of working directly with you, but what I do have is an appreciation for your leadership and involvement as a key member of the senior administration of WPI. When I think about that, I do so with respect and perhaps more importantly, admiration for the manner in which you conducted your work. The student affairs arena is at the heart of the everyday life of WPI, and you brought a sense of style, class, commitment, and vision to the students and to the administration, as well as the world around us. You did this with warmth, fairness, collegiality, and vision. And that created an environment that produced success, involvement, caring, and enjoyment at every turn. Perhaps equally important in what you brought to the position was your leadership and involvement in the creation of WPI's campus center. While there was a general appreciation for the need for a campus center, you had a vision of what such a facility could and should be. Your work with John Miller, who by the way says to say hi and congratulations to you, the trustees and the architects to design the facility to meet WPI's needs for decades to come is perhaps your greatest legacy. Unfortunately, it is underappreciated by many, but to me, it's one of the most important things that you did for this college community. Today, the Student Center, as we all know, stands as a focal point of campus life. The facility is functional in every way. It's designed with a quality and a clear vision of programmatic needs that stands at the heart of the campus, both physically and socially. As I said, it's to me perhaps your single largest achievement of your years at WPI. Perhaps we should have named it the Richardson Campus Center. Incredible job, Janet. In closing, Let me reiterate that your service to WPI was extraordinary in many ways. It was always professional, quietly innovative, warm, collegial, and done with a style that everyone would do well to replicate. I do wish I had had more of an opportunity to work directly with you, but watching you and being involved with you was an inspiration and a very special event for me and everybody else at WPI. I wish I could hug you tonight to express my admiration for what you've meant to WPI and to tell you how much I respect you, both as a person and as a friend. Congratulations. Mike?
The Richardson Campus Center definitely has a ring to it. Thank you, Steve. Just another reminder, I know Janet will cherish this word cloud, so please, please participate. Put some words on the tree and also type some stories in the chat. We're keeping an eye. Our final speaker is Philip Clay. He's WPI's president for student affairs, who spent many of his years working side by side with Janet. Philip?
Thank you, Mike, and good evening, everyone. I'm thrilled to be part of this celebration honoring Janet, this year's recipient of the Goat Heads Award. As I was preparing my comments tonight, I kept coming back to the concept of legacy, something you just heard Steve Hebert talk about. When I think about legacy, I was thinking about the many ways that Janet's legacy has shaped my career and life, and in turn, the ways that Bernie Brown's legacy shaped Janet's. In my office, I have some items that Janet and Bernie had in their offices. They serve as my spiritual talismans and daily reminders of their deeply felt legacies. Now, to even attempt to summarize Janet's legacy and all that I've learned from her over the 20 plus years that we worked together is a daunting task. Some of the lessons that I learned were explicit, but most were gained from simply watching and observing how Janet inhabited her many roles at WPI. First and foremost, Janet always kept students at the center of everything that she did. She was a fierce advocate for student needs and a champion of student success. You've just heard from Mike and Joyce and Nancy and Rachel about the tremendous impact that she had on them during their time as students. And those are just some of the hundreds of stories that could be shared. And how did this remarkable woman do this? By always demonstrating genuine care and compassion. A colleague noted that one of Janet's superpowers was that she had Jedi empathy. When you spoke with her, you felt that she connected with you on an almost molecular level. No matter how personal or private your concerns, Janet always made you feel like she truly understood where you were coming from. And when you work in student affairs, there is never a typical day, and things rarely go as planned. Janet's ability to refocus her attention to address the unexpected, more pressing priority was enviable. And if you walked into her office with an issue, she never made you feel like you were interrupting her, even when you were. She was always present and took whatever time was needed to make sure you felt heard and supported. Janet also taught me about the importance of showing up and attending student events, whether that was a Black History Month dinner or a jazz ensemble concert or project presentation day. Showing up was a simple yet powerful way to demonstrate to students that you really cared about them and what they were doing. Now, admittedly, we typically spent the majority of our time with either student leaders or students that were encountering some kind of difficulty at WPI. I remember that one time Janet decided that we didn't spend enough time with the average WPI student, and her solution was that we were going to go to the dining hall and eat with students. And so we marched over to Morgan Dining for lunch and descended upon a group of unsuspecting first-year students. We settled in, and Janet immediately started asking questions of the group. Where are you from? What are you majoring in? What activities are you involved with? How did you select WPI? The questions came in rapid-fire succession as Janet moved from student to student, trying to learn more about them. Now, after a couple of minutes of being enthusiastically peppered with questions, one of the students said she had to leave to go to get ready for class. And her roommate immediately said, "I need to go too." And they left. A couple more minutes of questioning, the third student sheepishly got up to leave, leaving a single woman at the table with us, looking like a deer caught in the headlights, wanting to run, but frozen in her politeness of not knowing how to escape. I looked her in the eye and said, "You don't need to stay. You can go if you need to." She nodded and said, "Thank you," and immediately bolted. So in the course of 5 minutes, Janet had cleared the table and we were left to enjoy our lunch in Morgan alone. And so just as Janet taught me the importance of showing up, she also taught me that sometimes it's better if you don't. Janet was tenacious and taught me about strategy and building consensus. And nowhere is this quality better demonstrated in the construction of the Rubin Campus Center that Steve Hebert was just talking about. It took Janet years of work developing strategy, doing research and benchmarking, building coalitions, and empowering students to work with her to advocate for the construction of this important building. Janet understood and taught me that the best way to serve students was to work in partnership across the university to achieve your goals. The Rubin Campus Center literally transformed our campus and created a gathering place for all members of our community. The building opened in January of 2001, and one of my most powerful memories of my time at WPI came 8 months later on the morning of September 11th. As community members watched the news and the images of the burning towers on the Campus Center televisions, Janet and I moved from group to group, checking on students, trying to make sense of the madness and mourning together. Janet's vision for the Campus Center was fully realized on that day. And the building continues to be a place where all members of the WPI community can gather to celebrate, to mourn, to connect, to support each other, and to live. Finally, Janet taught me about the importance of hiring good people and investing in their growth as professionals. Her commitment to talent development included giving people opportunities to try new things, to be on higher profile committees, to work beyond their current job description, and gain valuable experiences to prepare them for their next position, whether that was at WPI or elsewhere. I am the poster child of Janet's commitment and skills in this area. In a very real sense, I owe the longevity of my career at WPI over these 27 years to her. As a manager, I have tried to pay it forward by fostering the same commitment to members of my team, providing them with opportunities for growth and development. In conclusion, as I journey through my day, I'm constantly aware that I am standing on the shoulders of the ones who came before me. And so for me, those shoulders belong to Janet Richardson, my mentor and dear friend, who taught me so many lessons, but the most important one of which was to always lead from the heart. Back to you, Mike.
Thank you, Philip, for those heartfelt comments and tribute. Thank you again to all our speakers for your kind words about Janet. It's certainly been a pleasure learning about Janet and her great contributions to our university through your eyes and voices and stories. It's now my pleasure to invite Dusty Klauber of the Class of 67 and Chairman of the Alumni Association Citation Committee to present Janet's award.
Good evening. Janet, congratulations. It's my honor to read your citation, but before I do, I'd just like to say that we've heard you described in a lot of different terms this evening. There's one you probably haven't heard yet, and it's one held by the Citations Committee. You are definitely low-hanging fruit. Janet Bagan Richardson is well known to the WPI community for her decades of work providing an enriching and safe campus life experience for undergraduate and graduate students. She is a trusted advisor, mentor, and a friend to very many. Richardson began her career in student affairs as an assistant and area coordinator at the Pennsylvania State University in 1977. In 1980, she joined WPI as assistant dean of students and began a long and distinguished career in student affairs, her responsibility growing significantly over the next 15 years. In 1995, she was named assistant vice president for student affairs and dean of student life. She became associate vice president in 2000. In 2004, Janet was named vice president for student affairs, responsible for the oversight and delivery of student services to more than 4,000 students. She oversaw 11 departments and a budget of $10.5 million. In short, if a program had anything to do with a student's experience at WPI, Janet played a role in shaping and successfully leading it. As vice president of this critical area of the university, Richardson also served on the president's cabinet of advisors, where she helped strengthen WPI's financial operations and performance. She also helped guide the university's brand development strategy and the campaign for communicating the value proposition for a WPI degree. She participated in strategic planning, played leadership roles in reducing the discount rate, increasing applications for both undergraduate and graduate admissions, increasing retention rate, and improving communications between various WPI constituencies, including alumni. The list of her many achievements is long. Richardson began and successfully brought 120 companies to WPI for a campus career fair in 2012 to recruit students for internships and employment. She earned 3 ExxonMobil Bernard Harris Summer Science Grants to host 50 underrepresented children at WPI for a science camp. She developed and led the emergency preparedness team, writing the manual operation manual, training a team of over 25 responders, staging mock disasters and tabletop exercises for training purposes. She created the student conduct process and the hearing board, which included both students and faculty. She developed a 10-year master plan for housing and dining needs, and she served on the construction team for 2 residence halls and the Rubin Campus Center, which finally gave the student body a campus recreation center, a food court, and many other facilities and renovations. Even with all these responsibilities, Janet was a presence on campus among students. Students sought her counsel regarding career and graduate school advice, and she generously critiqued resumes and reviewed other credentials for students who asked for help. She supported students and their activities by advising their clubs, assisting with student government, and regularly attending their performances and competitions. Her care of and advocacy for students also extended to her work implementing numerous qualitative and quantitative instruments to assess the quality of life and student satisfaction on campus. Janet also developed and chaired the Trustee Mentor Program, which matches upper-class student leaders with WPI trustees for mentoring and guidance. This program has led to many fulfilling interactions and friendships over the more than 10 years of the program. Janet Bagan Richardson received her undergraduate degree from Salem State College and her MS and EDS from the State University of New York at Albany. She has also had many professional affiliations throughout her career, including serving as chair of the Chief Student Affairs Officers of the College of Worcester Consortium from 2008 to 2010, and is a member of the Board of Directors for Jewish Family Services of Worcester from 2010 to 2012, the year she served as the chair. Janet's work has laid the foundation for the WPI community of today, one that has the strength and fortitude, the compassion and kindness to be successful even in the face of challenges as a global pandemic. She continues to be counted on as a trusted advisor, mentor, and a friend by countless alumni. The WPI Alumni Association is really proud to present Janet Bagan Richardson with the 2020 Coach Head Award for Lifetime Commitment to WPI. Janet, I've got your award here. I'm going to hand it to you. Somehow I get cut off.
Thank you very much, Dusty. I am going to now read some remarks. I am humbled and honored to be the recipient of the 2020 Goat's Head Award for Lifetime Commitment to WPI from the Alumni Association, especially because it comes from you, my former students. I have so many great memories of our times together. I must say that in these days of COVID, I am more than happy to be retired. I only had to deal with swine flu and H1N1, mere blips on the radar these days. I can't imagine what it's like for those of you still working in higher education today. Lori, I wish you and your team well, and Philip. I would like to dedicate this award to former Vice President for Student Affairs, Bernie Brown, my mentor and former boss of 25 years. He embodies the true commitment to a lifetime serving WPI. Bernie taught me everything I know about how to be present for students, to listen, and to be a change agent. He gave me my first copy of Two Towers, and he taught me the history of WPI, though he never got me into the Skull Tomb. He introduced me to many of the important people in the lives of students, John Van Alstyne, Bill Grogan, Bill Trask, Father Scanlon, Carmen Brown, Steve Hebert, and Helen Vassallo, to name a few. We had a lot of laughs back then, but mostly we had a lot of plans. We knew what an excellent institution it was and what an even better institution it could be for our students. We talked a lot about what was already working and what was still needed. We knew that the in-class portion of the college was first rate, but that student satisfaction with the out-of-class experience was lower. Students wanted more ways to connect with their peers, better and more residential facilities, better food, study and meeting space, more leadership opportunities, better food, better recreation facilities, a campus center, a safer campus, and greater career opportunities for students and alumni. We set these student expectations as our goals, and though in some cases it took years to accomplish, I am proud to say that we were able to deliver on each one of our objectives. Increasing the number of women and minority students and providing services to lead to their success was also a goal. And I am so proud to see the level of inclusion of each of these groups over the years and the leadership roles they have taken on as their numbers have grown. I am also proud to have been involved with starting the first LGBTQ student organization on campus and to have helped make WPI a place where all students feel welcome. I have always told family and friends that I had the best job in the world. I came to work every day doing what I loved, facilitating student success. That's really what my job was, facilitating student success and satisfaction. And you made it easy by being the brightest, most driven students that a college knows. I came to WPI thinking that I would stay for about 5 years and then move on. But after just a short time, I couldn't imagine working anywhere else. So many of you started out as students and became lifelong friends. I have so enjoyed going to your weddings, reconnecting at reunion, meeting your children, and consulting with you about job opportunities, even now in my retirement. As students, you kept me young. I learned all the latest jargon from you, four-letter words included. When you talked to me about problems you were having in differential equations, I must admit that I never understood a single word you were saying to me, but I genuinely sympathized with you. I have fond memories of you racing into my office to tell me that you passed your comp exam, and not so fond memories of you asking me how you were going to tell mom and dad that you just failed your first class. We sure weathered a lot of changes together. When I arrived in 1980, keg parties on the quad were in full swing on Spree Day. Some of you were saying, what's Spree Day? Everyone went to Deka. The only phones in the residence halls were pay phones and no one would answer them. Punch cards went out the windows at the end of the year and Fridays at the pub were a regular thing. And students stood in line at 6 a.m. to sign up for job interviews. Oh, how times have changed. Some things that I'll always remember. Having a legacy arrive on move-in day with her family in tow, only to discover that I had mistakenly assigned Martina Gorski as Martin Gorski to a male double in Trowbridge House. Filled to capacity and through a lot of tears, mine I think, we finally moved her in with an RA temporarily. Let's see, taking the RAs to Camp Harrington for team building activities and then discovering that the instructor actually expected me to zip line as well as the students. Staying late in the evening so Warren Smale could try to teach me Excel spreadsheets in preparation for our campus center report and presentation to the Board of Trustees. Oh, how I miss you, Warren. Taking students, faculty, and trustees, including Judy Nitch, she was always there, in early morning van trips to tour other universities to learn about what makes a successful campus center, and then doing it all over again for the recreation center. Having an RA who held a second job at Ralph's Tavern, who was spending a little more time on that job than the one I was paying her for, in issuing her an ultimatum, which she remembers verbatim to this day. Don't you, Nancy? And getting a call that someone had cut down a prized Colorado blue spruce tree from the president's lawn, and that the president's wife had followed the very distinctive needles through the snow and up the front steps of a certain fraternity house. And finally, watching with pride on 32 occasions as each of you crossed the stage to receive your diploma. Except for the years, that is, when Bernie assigned me to read the names of all of the graduates. Do you know how many syllables there are in most Thai names? I still haven't forgiven him for that. I loved my time at WPI, but I am loving retirement as well. Together with my husband, Don, we are, or should I say that pre-COVID, we were enjoying regular travel. We are now grandparents, which we adore. And we participate in childcare for our 3.5-year-old granddaughter. We love seeing her and our son and daughter-in-law weekly. I am enjoying gardening and I am passionate about playing duplicate bridge. So although I miss the opportunity to play a guiding role in the lives of students, I love my new life. You too have moved on to another phase in your lives. I know you have fond memories of your time at WPI, but I bet that what you remember most are the relationships you developed and the talents and skills you refined, not just in the classroom, but through leadership roles you assumed in student organizations or from a volunteer activity. That was what I remembered most from my college experience. And it's what led me to a career in student services. It was a fabulous career, and I was blessed to spend most of it at WPI with you. In closing, I want to thank you again for honoring me with the 2020 Goat's Head Award for lifetime commitment to WPI, and I will count this as one of my greatest achievements. It will always remind me of you, the most talented alumni in the country. I want to thank all of the organizers of this event from the offices of Alumni Relations and Lifetime Engagement, who put in numerous hours coordinating the details. My genuine thanks to Mike Shore, Dusty Klauber, Mark McCauley, and the rest of the executive board, and to all of the panelists tonight. And to those of you who took the time to drop me a note or to offer your words of support. I wish you all a great evening and a successful homecoming. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Janet, and congratulations.
Thanks.
Janet wins the Goat's Head Award. I'm actually envisioning everyone standing on their feet right now and applauding for you. That would be happening if it was face to face. We're also excited for you and beyond grateful for all that you've done for us and for WPI. Thank you again. At this time, it's my honor to welcome WPI's 16th president, Lori Leshin, to offer some remarks. Lori?
Thank you so much. It is wonderful to see so many friends of WPI on the participants list here on our Zoom tonight. I want to thank you all for being with us and for helping to keep our community together in this most unusual time, probably most unusual homecoming in the history of WPI. Janet, I am sad to say that I am probably the person on the call that knows you the least.
I know.
But I know the impact that you've had, and I am so thrilled to be a part of this special celebration of you and your incredible contributions to WPI. And just one little story of my own connection to your amazingness. I started, after I came to WPI, a group called the Women's Impact Network, where we bring women alumni together. They join this group, they pool their resources to do great philanthropic work on the campus to advance causes around women. And actually at our very first women's retreat weekend, I talked a bit about my own path and my own history and about the importance not only of mentoring, but of advocacy for other women, and talked some about people who had kicked the door down for me in my own path. And we did a little exercise among the group of incredible alumni, many of whom are here tonight. And I asked them, you know, tell me a story about someone at WPI who kicked down a door for you. And there were a lot of familiar names that were raised, names like Grogan and Benet and Bernie Brown, but your name was mentioned really often as well. It's very clear that you had a lasting impact decades later on these incredible women. And that impact was lasting and really profound. So I'm honored to be here with you tonight because of that impact that you've had on our students. And you know, and you all know that our students now, as always, come to WPI with great aspirations to make a difference in the world, but they don't always have the skills when they arrive to make their impact. And so, of course, through our classes and through our incredible projects, we do a lot to develop their skills. But the truth is, they spend the vast majority of their time not in class. And so so many of the skills they acquire and require in order to make their impact come from outside the classroom. And you, Janet, really set the standard for a great student experience at WPI, one that does make a positive impact that lasts, again, well beyond the time that our students spend at WPI. And of course, I would also be remiss if I did not thank you directly and personally for the amazing mentoring and training that you did with Philip Clay, who you heard from, we all heard from earlier, our current Vice President of Student Affairs. You all could never understand how lost we would be without him at this moment. He is on an hourly basis guiding our response to COVID. And yes, we are so grateful for you lighting the path for him and probably kicking down some doors there as well. This week, I'm spending some time reflecting on the life and legacy of the great Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. And I've been thinking a lot about women leaders who blaze the trail for those of us that come after. My mother was one of those women and a feminist activist when I was a little girl. But the truth is that perhaps more than anyone else at WPI, Janet, you blazed the trail for me. And for that, I'm incredibly grateful. As the first woman vice president at WPI, you made room for the first woman president. And so I just want to thank you for that as well. I'm very grateful. You certainly exemplify the very best of WPI, bringing people together, advancing our students, personal growth, commitment to community. And again, I'm just thrilled to be here to honor and celebrate you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for all you've done. Congratulations. And I'll just close by speaking to the group more broadly. You know, it's an intense time in the world. It's an intense time here at WPI. Here we are right smack in the middle of a term. I think a few months ago, many of us would never have imagined we'd be here with students back on campus and being back in class and actually be operating the institution. And it has been an incredible moment for the team to step up and come together. And as we do that, I think all of us count on and draw strength from the students, the faculty, and the staff who came before us, whose legacy that we help to advance and grow by how we act, how we show up, how we succeed in this moment. So your resolve, all of our alumni, all of our colleagues on the Zoom here, you have inspired us to keep going and to keep going in a very WPI way, which is just knock down the problems one at a time until we could finally say, we're going to bring the students back. We figured out how to do that, and we're going to do that safely. And so all of you, Janet and everybody else on the phone, that really is part of your legacy at WPI, helping us be here today for our students. And the joy on their faces probably was only met by the joy on ours, seeing them back on campus after having not been here for 6 months. My goal always as president is to make you all proud and to make you all proud of your alma mater, make you proud of WPI, of the place that you know and love, in a homecoming sense, alma mater. I know a lot of alums on the phone. I hope we're doing that with how we're showing up in this moment, again, benefiting from all of the brilliance and the strength and the commitment of all of you. So I want to wish you all a happy homecoming weekend. And once again, congratulations, Janet.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Lori. I'd like to display right now on the screen is the word cloud that we have asked all of you and our alumni, faculty, and staff to contribute to. These words are how the WPI community sees you, Janet. A friend, leader, advocate, visionary, trailblazer, and so much more. You're the embodiment of the Goat's Head Award, Janet, and we thank you for all you did for our great school. In addition to presenting Janet with this award today, the Alumni Association will honor her contributions to WPI by making a contribution of its own. In the next academic year, as part of its annual gift to the university, the Alumni Association will present a deserving undergraduate student with a $5,000 global project scholarship in Janet's honor. We have a lot to be proud of here at WPI. On behalf of the Alumni Association, I congratulate Janet and all of our 2020 award recipients. As you may recall, our annual Alumni Weekend celebration had to be canceled this year, but we are looking forward to presenting awards to some very deserving alumni in the June of 2021. Each of these award recipients, Janet included, are role models for our students and alumni, and we look forward to their continued engagement with our university. I'd also like to say a special thank you to Mike Shore and our friends in the Office of Alumni Relations who assisted us in putting together this program today, as well as each of our speakers. I hope you've enjoyed this program and all of WPI's virtual homecoming programs this week. As a reminder, and as I just mentioned, we are looking forward to Alumni Weekend in 2021, which is taking place June 3rd through June 6th. I hope I will see you there. Thank you again for being here tonight. Have a great evening.